table shoulder flexion, there's a few things that we want to do to make sure that we're set up properly. First, I want to have a nice stable chair to sit in. I want to make sure it's not wobbly, it's not going to go anywhere. I have a nice stable surface next to me, such as a countertop, a kitchen table. That's not too high that makes us have to reach our arm up, but it's not too low that makes us have to bend forward. And thirdly, I want to make sure I have something that's going to allow me to slide relatively easy over that surface. So here I have a towel. So to perform this exercise, you're going to get your arm onto that stable surface. And you'll also notice I'm kind of set up on the side. So I'm not set up directly behind that table or countertop or whatever I'm using. I'm towards the side. So in this case, I'm going to be stretching out my right shoulder. So I would be on the left side of that table or counter. And I'm stretching out my left shoulder. I would be on the opposite side. So on the right side of that table or counter. If my shoulder is too sore and lifted up to that surface, I'll use my good arm to get my shoulder up. And then once I'm here, I like to have that free hand just kind of on that arm or on the wrist forearm area to help me with the stretch and to also control that arm and make sure it doesn't fall off the table or anything like that. What I want to do is I want to use my body weight to stretch out my shoulder. So I'm not going to be actively thinking about using my shoulder, bringing my shoulder into flexion or anything like that. I want you to think that your shoulder is just along for the ride. So what that means is I'm going to just completely relax that arm, find a position of the hand that works comfortable for you. I like to kind of have the side of my hand on that table. It opens up the shoulder a little bit so we're not pinching anything if we go into internal rotation. So I have that hand relaxed, arm relaxed, that free hand is on that arm for stabilization. And then I'm going to use my body weight to push my arm forward. Okay, because what I do as I push my body forward, what I'm simulating is shoulder flexion. So that arm coming up directly overhead. The benefit of using my body weight is I'm not actually stimulating or activating my shoulder muscles, so I won't cause aggravation or pain. So I'm gonna use my body moving forward. And early on, we just wanna go to a point where we feel a good stretch. Stretching might cause slight discomfort, but there's a difference between slight stretching discomfort and sharp shooting pain. So if we go forward and I start to get sharp shooting pain in my shoulder or down my arm, that means we've gone too far. You don't want to go that far. So I'm just going to lean forward slightly, again, using my free hand to kind of help with that stretch. I'm using my body weight to push myself forward. I find a good stretch. I hold that for a couple seconds, probably about 5 seconds. Then I'm going to use my body weight, lean back, come back to my resting position, and that's one repetition. So we're gonna get our set number of repetitions using, again, my body to push forward, hold for 5 seconds, use that body and free hand to pull myself back, and that's my second repetition. I like to do this on both sides, even if I have a good shoulder. It's good to keep shoulder mobility in both shoulders. We don't wanna overcompensate one shoulder compared to another. Again, this is a very good early rehab stretching exercise to work on range of motion without aggravating the shoulder by actually activating our muscles.